On this episode of the Massive Agent Podcast, we are super stoked to sit down with Kim Garcia, the Senior VP of VaynerExperience. She's the one in charge of Agent 2021, and we'll talk about what the event is, why you should be there, and why it will become the biggest, best, most important real estate conference out there.
The Massive Agent Podcast. With lead generation tips and strategies to get you more leads and sell more homes.
I love to buy houses. I like to sell houses.
It takes brass balls to sell real estate.
Wait a minute.
The leads are weak. You're weak.
I've had better.
Oh, have I got your attention now?
Here's your host, Dustin Brohm.
Hey, what's going on, Massive Agents? Welcome to episode number 54 of the Massive Agent Podcast. Woo! I am so stoked for today. We have a very special guest. She works directly for Gary Vaynerchuk. She runs the VaynerExperience division of VaynerMedia. So all the events they do, VoiceCon, Agent 2021, the private events they do for brands, she runs the show there. She was actually a guest on Gary Vee's Ask Gary Vee show, episode 276. So if you want to see more of Kim Garcia, go check out the Ask Gary Vee show on YouTube, episode 276. And she will be on with us in just a second. If you guys are new to the show or just joining, welcome. I am Dustin Brohm, your host. This is the Massive Agent Podcast, which of course is the number one podcast on the planet that starts with the word massive. Hey, it's science. Like, it just is. And so we're proud about that. I am the founder of the Massive Agent Society, massiveagentsociety.com. Go check that out if you want to learn how to get more leads and become a Facebook ads master. I'm a national speaker, trainer, and coach for both real estate and mortgage companies. I'm a realtor in Salt Lake City with eXp Realty and the co-founder of leadswebinar.com with my good friend Jason Frazier from The Agent Marketer. Okay, today is the day that we finally make the big announcement and tell you guys what we've been teasing, what we've been alluding to over these last few weeks on social media and our Instagram stories, something that you might have seen that we're calling the Industry Syndicate. It's time to make the announcement, and we'll tell you what it is, who's involved, and why we're doing it, because this Industry Syndicate that we've put together, this is the first of its kind in the real estate industry. And I don't just mean for real estate agents. I mean any corner of the real estate world, like interior design, home decoration, or home decor, I guess they'd call it, home inspectors, insurance. Like, this has not been done in the real estate industry until now. And we're proud to announce it right now. So over the last month or so, I've teamed up with two other founders of this thing, Jason Frazier and Phil Treadwell, who's the host of the Mortgage Marketing Expert podcast. And we have been putting together a media network of other shows, podcasts, flash briefings, Facebook Live shows, any show that is popular and that's hot and that's in line with, you know, the new school, not old school thinking, not, you know, the old school, like, you know, crusty, dusty stuff. Wow, that's a weird explanation, but you know what I mean? Like the new school, if you're listening to this show, you're in the new school. So there's a bunch of other shows out there in our industry that are in line but they talk to different audiences or they have different spins on the content they do. Well, we're teaming up with all of them. We're putting together the industry's first media network. It's called the Industry Syndicate. There are 15 shows involved, and that's with 12 different hosts. And because some of us have podcasts and flash briefings. And so the way that this is going to work is the Industry Syndicate will be the one-stop shop, one singular place, one singular organization for great real estate content that is, that you consume online. Okay. Now we looked at, like, you know, look at ABC and NBC in TV, how, you know, their networks and they have all their shows, right? And then in radio, you have Westwood One, you have Cumulus that have all their different radio shows that they syndicate, right? Why don't we do that in the real estate industry? Well, we just did. We already have. It's called the Industry Syndicate. The difference here is instead of us as the syndicate telling each show how they can do it, who can be on the show, who can't, who can be their sponsor, who can't, how to, you know, creatively how to do their show, we have no interest in that. The reason why we're aligning with these shows and why we're teaming up with them is they already do a great job. And So they're doing their shows their way, full creative control. We just see a ton of power, not just for us as show hosts, but for you guys as the real estate industry to have one central place to go to find great real estate content and discover new stuff that's similar to what you're already listening to. So we're going to have our own app for the industry, for the industry syndicate. It's going to be our own app. All the shows are going to have, you know, their content in there. It's going to be kind of its own social network in a way for you to connect with other people in this community. Think of how cool this is. Like, my show has its own audience. Jason Fraser's show has its own audience. The other shows have their own audience. And now we're able to combine all these different communities into one, in one central location. It's going to be so powerful. And, moving forward, podcasting, Alexa, all of that is just going to be that much more powerful and that much more. There's going to be so much more content coming out, so many more people listening. There was a stat the other day that the day after Christmas, the Alexa app was the number one app in the App Store because there were tens of millions of people in one day activating new devices. If that's not telling, if that's not all you need to know, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do to convince you that voice marketing is next. So you can go to industrysyndicate.com, check out all the other shows that are involved. I'm super excited because today I finally get to make the announcement of who else is part of the Industry Syndicate moving forward. So we've got the Mortgage Marketing Expert podcast hosted by Phil Treadwell, the Agent Marketer podcast with Jason Fraser, the Agent Marketer Flash with Jason Fraser, that's his flash briefing, this Massive Agent podcast, Massive Agent Minute, that's our Alexa flash briefing, the Modern Agent podcast with Rick Gonzalez, Prime Real Estate with Justin Conico, REC Experience with Jazz Takar up in Toronto, Canada, Agent Rise podcast, formerly known as the Onion Juice podcast, with Neil Mathweg. He's a part of this as well. The Tech Nest podcast with Nate Smoyer, the voice of social sales, Chelsea Pites, her podcast and her flash briefing by the same name. Mindshare, the Mindshare podcast with David Greenspan. The Daily Elo Life show, that's a Facebook Live show, a daily Facebook Live show. He's also going to be doing a podcast and putting that out. That's hosted by Josh Pitts. And then the Real Estate Sessions podcast hosted by Bill Risser. So this is the Industry Syndicate. If you guys haven't heard of these other shows, go to industrysyndicate.com, check them out. There's links to all of the shows, info about the host, what the show is about. You can connect with them. You can learn more about this Industry Syndicate, what it means, and really, why we're doing it. Because this is one of those things that I think could be such a great resource for the whole industry. I see it all the time in Facebook groups. What are the best podcasts to listen to? And, there's all these different people who recommend different things, and it's all just scattered. And it's all up to the iTunes search on who they say you should listen to. Well, we're creating our own resource and teaming up. We're all going to be kind of cross-promoting each other and having each other as guests and all of that. There's so much power in working together to build a massive media network within the real estate industry. And the shows that we have now, this is just the beginning. We're going to be branching into other parts of the real estate industry. Real estate investor shows. That's a huge segment of the real estate industry. Real estate investment. There's home design, all sorts of stuff that we're going to be announcing soon. So go to industrysyndicate.com. Follow the Industry Syndicate on social media as well. Look for all of the different hosts. They're going to be announcing this and what it means to them and how they're going to be using it. They're going to be announcing it on their shows this week, the first couple of weeks of January. So go check them out. But so stoked to announce this and super stoked to see kind of what it evolves to and what it becomes over the next 12 to 18 months. And before we get into the interview with Kim Garcia, the senior VP of VaynerExperience, which is so freaking cool that she agreed to be on the show. Next week, we'll have an announcement about the Massive Agent Society and the changes coming there. We have some of the biggest issues people have had or biggest concerns is they're like, hey, I want to join the society, but my market's already taken. There's already someone who claimed my market. I can't join now. Well, we're going to solve that. It's not going to encroach on them and what they own and claim with their market, but we're going to give an extra option that anyone in your market can do, including yourself. Also, some people have said they just want to be a part of a coaching program. They don't really care about the Facebook ads database and, they don't want to pay one-on-one coaching prices. We have a solution for that as well. So stay tuned next week for more for the big changes coming to the Massive Agent Society. Go to MassiveAgentSociety.com if you have not heard of it and you want to see what our Facebook ad database and lead gen coaching program is all about. Today, we have Kim Garcia on the show. So excited for this because she is she runs the show, Agent 2021, as you've heard me talk about, that I'm speaking at on January 17th in Miami. She runs the show. This is her event. It's the second year they've done it. She works directly for and with Gary Vaynerchuk. And so we get to hear from the horse's mouth, so to speak, exactly what the event is, why it's different from other real estate conferences, why you should be there. Super excited for this interview. So let's get into it with Kim Garcia. All right, guys, we're sitting here with Kim Garcia, Senior VP of VaynerExperience. She's been with VaynerMedia for the last 7 years, and she is the one basically spearheading Agent 2021 and all of the events that VaynerMedia does, which I, having gone to VoiceCon in New York this last year, I know how you guys do amazing events. So, Kim, welcome to the Massive Agent Podcast. How's it going?
Thank you. Thanks for having me. I'm so happy to be here, Dustin.
It's going really well. Awesome. Yeah, we're super stoked to have you. It's like a dream come true to have been selected to speak at Agent 2021. And, you know, we're just a couple weeks away. And so I wanted to bring you on and let you speak to the Massive Agent audience about the event, what it is, how it works, like why they should be there, why it's different from, you know, all the other real estate conferences that are out there, which there's like 1,000 of them, maybe more.
There are.
Yeah. So real quick, Kim, tell us about Agent 2021 that's happening on January 17th in Miami.
Yep. No problem. We're super excited. So we're coming into our second year. Last year, the inaugural year was kick-ass. The response, real estate was actually our largest track. So Agent 2021 covers real estate, insurance. We added mortgage this year, which is different than last year. We just had such a demand from mortgage brokers. Obviously, it aligns with the other verticals. And then we have auto dealers as well. So that's one big change is we're including mortgage this year, which I think from just like a biz dev and a networking perspective, I think is pretty important to have them in the mix. Sure. So excited about that. That's actually based on early ticket sales right now, real estate and mortgage are actually our biggest attendee purchases. So those should be big tracks. I think coming out of last year, we took a lot of feedback. Thankfully the response is super positive. So we made some improvements just based on a little bit of feedback that we had from last year, which no surprise, people wanted more Gary. So we will be giving them more Gary. He's going to be doing the opening keynote with Matt Higgins. Matt Higgins is a shark, on Shark Tank. He's also a huge, just sort of entrepreneur, self-starter, works for Stephen Ross, who owns the Dolphins and the stadium and all that good stuff. He has an incredible story. So I think it's going to be really interesting for attendees to hear his story. He is like the true definition of hustle. So it'll be really fun to hear, Gary and him sort of share the stage and talk about their journey. And then we actually are announcing today another keynote, which will happen during the lunch hour. I'm incredibly, incredibly excited. I don't know if I should even say who it is. Let me see. I guess by the time this airs, your listeners will be aware potentially. But he is he's a Florida native, which I'm stoked about. He currently lives in Harlem. He is going to be hosting a show on Viceland. His name is John Henry. And he has also an incredible story. He was Forbes 30 under 30. He's part of Ebony's Power 100. He is now a partner at Harlem Capital, which is an early stage VC firm. And his show on Viceland is actually called The Hustle, which it falls in line with sort of the Vayner ethos, if you will. So he's going to be doing our lunchtime keynote, and then Gary's going to close out the day. So we're sort of going to get to attendees will get sort of two more inspirational speeches from Gary, and then John Henry will be in the middle, which will be awesome. So in addition to that, we're going to, Facebook is going to be back for their second year. They're building on their presence last year. Last year, attendees slammed the Facebook Lounge, which was incredible. It was the hunger for education from our attendees is so important to this event. And so Facebook is bringing Instagram, and they're also going to be doing bringing Blueprint on site. So there will be Instagram Stories School, which if you've listened to anything Gary has said probably in the last year, Instagram Stories right now is your probably greatest investment in terms of ROI on social. So Instagram is going to be leading sessions across all industries. So in each of the industry tracks, Instagram Stories will be a dedicated panel. And then they'll have an
on-site
presence.
That'll be people directly from the companies who are there doing this training?
Yeah.
Wow, that's
awesome. That's right. So it's the only panel across all four industries that is led by a partner. In all of our other sort of panel and industry topics, we have a Vayner representative because we want to always make sure that we have our Vayner POV within the education piece. And then we obviously bring on speakers and partners to do the rest. But this Instagram Stories is the one dedicated Instagram only led panel for all four industries. So that's going to be, it's going to be incredibly insightful. They're going to do creative best practices. They're going to give strategy. They're going to obviously talk about the paid media product. So it's going to be incredibly insightful. And then in addition to that, they're going to have an on-site cabana. We're having partner cabanas on the field this year. And so they're going to have a massive presence there, which will be really nice. So attendees will get that one-on-one time with them to ask direct questions about challenges they may be having with the platforms in general. So
I'm
really excited about that. Yeah. So it's nice that they're building on last year. They just saw a ton of value and they were like, you know what, this is, they have an incredible small business group. So they really want to obviously help educate attendees. So that is going to be excited. And then also we heard from last year's attendees that they wanted more sort of networking and biz dev opportunities. I think last year, and similarly this year, to be honest with you, our whole goal for this event is to educate. And so last year we were really focused on the education piece, and we had attendees in sessions pretty much throughout the entire day. It was like start to finish with a few keynotes mixed in. This year we've added in a bit more networking opportunities. So the day before the event, which this is also something we heard from attendees, is they just wanted a night or an evening or a few hours to get to know other attendees and do sort of a kickoff. So the night before, we're doing a VIP dinner for VIP ticket holders for Gary, which Gary is hosting. It's very small. We're keeping it limited so that everyone gets their time with Gary to ask, you know, direct questions of him. So it's being capped at 75. So those are strictly for VIP ticket holders. And then for general admission ticket holders, we're going to have an opening night reception and that's obviously for all attendees and speakers that are welcome to attend that. And that will give an opportunity just, you know, to have folks mix and mingle before they jump into the event the following day. And then on event day, obviously kicks off. So I think one differentiator from this conference as opposed to other conferences, A, we're obviously focused specifically on social and digital. I think, you know, VaynerMedia as a whole and Gary, if you've listened to him, really understand where consumer attention is. And currently consumer attention is within the social and digital world. So we are specifically focused on those, like how to build your personal brand within social media. How do you leverage the media ads? What are creative best practices that you should be thinking about as you're developing your creative for storytelling? So I think we are solely focused on that. We want to make sure that, especially these industries, which have been slower to adopt in the past, digital practices, really can learn and walk away with the tools that they need to start implementing. And I think what is also different, I think a lot of conferences now that are happening are much more inspirational. I think that, they're much more of like a kick in the ass, which is great. Like, I think that, you know, you need that in your life and you need that in your business practice. And so you go into these events and you sort of get that kick in the ass, but then it's the what's next. and no one really knows what to do after they leave, other than they feel great and they feel inspired to do something. They just don't know what it is that they need to be doing.
Exactly.
And so we hope to fill that gap. Yeah, we hope to fill that gap. And not to mention, like, you can follow Gary and you can follow John Henry, and you're going to get the inspiration that you need for free. You don't need to buy an $800 ticket, right? So
right.
We want to make sure that people are walking away with, like, very, very specific tools to start implementing immediately. And we have amazing case studies from last year that I'm excited that we're going to be sharing on site. So we're excited about that. So, and then additionally, we heard from attendees last year that they wanted more VaynerMedia. So we obviously have a ton of speakers on all of our panels, but they wanted more one-on-one time with the VaynerMedia senior leaders. So we're going to be programming Cabana this year. So Lindsay Blum, who is a head of Vayner Talent, where she works with thought leaders on building their personal brand, sort of the Gary Vee model. She's going to be leading a session within the VaynerMedia Cabana, really going one-on-one with attendees on how they can grow their personal brands. And then we're also going to have Steve Babcock, who's our chief creative officer, leading creative sessions during the networking break. So there's going to be a lot more sort of interaction with Vayner, interaction with Gary, but then also just like much more programming, I think. Last year it was a little bit loose in our lounge, and I think we want to tighten that up just based on feedback from attendees. So, and then the level of speaker this year, I mean, we had, I was like amazed at the level of speaker we had in year one, only because like I mentioned earlier, these industries are sort of slower to adopt, so to find experts in the space is a little bit challenging, to be honest with you. And we had an incredible range of speakers last year. I think, you know, from a diversity perspective, from a gender perspective, those are really things that we're mindful of. We want to make sure that we're including all different sorts of POVs. And so this year we've really leveled that up, and I'm excited about the range of speakers that we have this year. It's going to be an incredible learning experience for everybody that attends. And I really do believe that this is probably one of the conferences that you will receive the most value from.
Well, if VoiceCon was any indicator of what this event's going to be like, I would say, yeah. I've got to say,
that's awesome.
You guys did such an awesome job with that. And it's one of those conferences that, like, because I've been to a bunch of conferences and, you know, I speak at Inman, and, you know, think what's awesome this year too, is you guys aren't competing with Inman over the same time, which is cool. Inman and like NAR and all these like traditional real estate and mortgage conferences, they're, like you said, they're very light on the tactics, very light on the education, and more on inspiration, or just like, hey, here, you can do these few things. We're not going to tell you how to do them, but you can go do these few things. But the value is in the networking at those events. And that's, I think,
right,
what brings people back. So the fact that you guys are doing the tactics, getting down into the details and having more networking, I think is going to be amazing. So I'm excited for that. And you mentioned the Cabanas on the field. If you guys don't know, this event is at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami, which is where the Miami Dolphins play. So that's going to be cool. And it's snowing here in Salt Lake City, so it's going to be nice to get into Miami weather.
That's right, man.
I'm excited for this. You do a good job of painting a picture of what it's going to be like. So,
Miami in January is always a good idea.
Yes. It's not dumb. So that's gonna be awesome. So I mentioned VoiceCon, and really quick, like, I just wanted to give you this feedback on it. VoiceCon was one of those events that really changed the course of my business and my vision in a positive way. So I went in there having launched this podcast in January of 2018. So I already had the podcast up and running for 4 or 5 months. That was in May, right? In New York City?
Yeah. Yep,
yes.
May. Mm-hmm.
Jesus, seems like 2 years ago. It's amazing how fast.
Tell me about it.
Yeah. But I went in there with a podcast. And I'm like, ooh, I'm already doing the voice marketing thing. I have a podcast, you know, like, that was kind of my subconscious thinking.
Yeah.
And then you get people from Diageo, the spirits company, and Chase Bank, and like, and Google, and all these people, they're like, oh no, then there's skills, there's flash briefings. Google will pretty soon be having audio results in the search results pages. And I'm like, oh my God, I've got to do a flash briefing. And I launched the flash briefing the very next week after I got home from New York. And
nice work.
Yeah, thank you. It was just very tactical. So it taught me how to do it and why I should do it.
I love it.
So, yeah. And you guys don't skimp.
That's awesome.
You don't skimp at your events.
No.
on the food and just everything. Like, some conferences you go and they just have a bunch of boxes stacked up with turkey sandwiches in it. You guys don't do that.
No, it's so funny that you mentioned that, because that's actually a big, so that's always a conversation we have going into the planning is obviously VaynerExperience is concerned about the experience of the attendee, but that is a big differentiator. And we've heard that from a lot of our attendees is that, wow, when we're going to one of your events, like there's really great food. We want people to feel like, you know, they're getting their money's worth, to be honest with you. And they're feeling fulfilled. I hate going to conferences and like having to be stuck with a box lunch and you don't have the fuel that you need to actually digest the information that's being thrown at you. So yeah, that's a big piece of it. So I appreciate you calling that out.
Absolutely. And you know, when you see that food's included, you're like, okay, cool. I don't need to worry about food. And then you're like, oh, it's a box lunch. That's awesome. And
right.
Some people don't want it. Some people don't need it. And you know, so that's cool. So Kim.
Yeah, no problem.
You've been with VaynerMedia for like 7 years crazy. And
the longest job I've ever had, by the way.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Well, that speaks 100%.
Volumes. I'm usually like a 3 year and then out, 2 to 3 year and then out because I just get bored. So I mean, being at a job this long does speak volumes to obviously Gary and the agency that he's built for sure.
That's so cool. So how did you, most of this audience, I think, are definitely Gary Vee fans, or they know who Gary Vee is, which I'm sure you're used to now, as everyone's like, "Oh, Gary Vee," he's just a very impactful, powerful presence, and he's a mentor from afar for me and for many, many others. What is it like working for Vayner? What's it like with Gary Vaynerchuk as a boss? What is, you know? Tell us about that, because I think that's interesting.
Yeah, totally. So it's funny, I was working at the Orange Bowl committee actually two jobs prior to VaynerMedia, and somebody like a marketing consultant that I had met down there virtually introduced me to Gary. So we were talking about social media. I was a very, very early adopter on Twitter. So I think I was like 2005 Twitter, but I really just saw like social media as a marketing channel, even in those early days. And so I always had an interest in sort of the power of the platforms. And so I started following Gary on Twitter because someone had mentioned him to me. And at that point there were not that many people on Twitter. So I started following him, and I also have an interest in wine, which he was at that point doing a lot of wine stuff. So started following him, and then fast forward, I moved on to Discovery Channel following the Orange Bowl, and was there for a couple of years, and then moved over to lead Discovery Channel's marketing efforts for a bunch of their shows. Shark Week was one of them. It was obviously still like pretty early days social, but you know, Facebook was starting to have like real chops in terms of marketing. And so I started to push, you know, my CMO was great at the time. He was super supportive and really trusted my gut. So was allowing me to explore, you know, how we could use social to sort of promote Shark Week and some of the other shows that I was working on. And so at that point, I think I'd seen that Gary tweeted out, "I'm launching an agency with my brother." And so I was in New York for an event, and I just cold called him and was like, "Hey, I'm doing this thing. Can we meet for 30 minutes and see if there's a way for us to work together?" And at that point, 30 minutes, I would be really hard to get 30 minutes with them these days, but I was able to carve out 30 minutes with them, and we hacked together a scope. And so I actually started off as his client. He and his brother were really my day-to-day contacts for a while. They worked on Shark Week, Moonshiners, Gold Rush, a bunch of the shows that I was working on.
Ooh, I love Gold Rush. That was my show back in the day.
Oh, really? That's so funny.
Yeah, I love that.
Yeah, that was a big, big one for me. I went up to the Yukon, and we did a shoot up there with all the guys. They're great guys.
Sweet.
So I started off as a client, and then 6 months later, Discovery moved me to LA. Around that time, Gary was starting to flirt with the idea of opening a San Francisco office. And so he reached out and just said, "Hey, like, do you have any interest in coming over to the agency side and sort of leading those efforts for me?" So it's funny because at that point in my career, I started thinking about, okay, like, I've worked for big brands. I always felt like I was sort of the nudge, like, why aren't we doing this? Or we should be doing more of this. And this is like smarter. Like, really, I was like that person that was always kind of pushing my senior leaders or just thinking about things differently. And so I was getting to the point in my career, I was like, you know what, if I think I'm so entrepreneurial or I think I'm so innovative, like going to work for this guy is really going to like test my chops there. So I made a decision for me as a professional. And I was also 5 months pregnant. So really not probably the greatest time to be jumping to a startup. But I, you know, he hired me 5 months pregnant. We moved to San Francisco and, you know, I've been with him since. For the majority of my time at Vayner, up until I launched VaynerExperience, I was overseeing our entertainment division. So I built out our entertainment team to about 60 plus employees that focused on creative strategy, analytics, media buying, planning, for TV networks, movie launches, sports, all that good stuff. So I did that for the majority of my time at Vayner, and then most recently, obviously, launched VaynerExperience 2 years ago. But working for Gary is, you know, he's the best boss I've ever had. He is incredibly supportive. He's incredibly trustful. He like pushes you. He understands people really well. And I think he like figures out how to push you in a way that aligns with a positive response. So I think, you know, what you see is what you get. For anybody that is a Gary Vee fan, he is pretty true to what you see. He obviously dials it up and at times to make certain points, but for the most part, that's who he is. He's a very, very kind person. He treats me as a person, not just as an employee, which I think is obviously important. Like, you know, we do like any company, we do you know, check-ins. He and I do check-ins, and he's always, you know, asking about my family first, really thinks about like what's going to fulfill me as a person, not just as an employee of his. And I think that's a huge differentiator for me in terms of working for somebody or a CEO. But yeah, he's the greatest mentor I could have possibly have imagined or stumbled upon. And I feel very fortunate to work for him.
You know, from afar, he just seems like one of those, like once in a lifetime, once in a generation, people, like personalities and leaders. And so it's super cool that he's documenting everything, because we get to see what seems like a large portion of what you're talking about and mm-hmm. learn from that, which is amazing. So I'm just super blessed and grateful that that I get to be a part of this Agent 2021 and kind of see how you guys do things behind the scenes and just be a part of the whole Vayner ecosystem for a year. It's humbling. So I appreciate the opportunity for that. And
yeah, of course, you earned it.
Well, thank you. There's like what, 6 or 8 of us speakers that rented a house just like 5 minutes away from the stadium. And so that's
no kidding.
Be
is that right?
Yeah, yeah. So that's gonna be fun.
Oh, and, that's awesome.
Yeah, and you know, I'm coming in Tuesday. Let me see here. So anyone who's not yet registered for Agent 2021, and first off, it's January 17th in Miami at Hard Rock Stadium. How can they get tickets? How can they go register for that? First off, are there still tickets available?
There are still tickets available. There are very few VIP tickets available. So I would say if you want that VIP experience, which is obviously dinner with Gary the night before, VIP registration, priority seating, all of that good sort of all the good stuff that comes along with a VIP package, I would say get those. But I think what's also fun about this event, which, you know, you asked me earlier about a differentiator, I think most conferences don't have a videographer package, but because we like respect the Gary Vee model of content and understand that that's like an important part to personal brand building, to your point, he documents everything and it's fun to sort of watch the journey. We offer a videographer package with all of our general admission and VIP tickets. So if you want to buy tickets, go to agent2021.com. And then if you're a listener for today, if you want to receive nearly 20% off your ticket, enter the code MASSIVEAGENT, and you'll receive that 20% off discount on all of the ticket packages. So whether you're coming in a general admission or you want to do your general admission plus your videographer pass, whatever that is, you'll get 20% off using the MASSIVEAGENT discount code.
Awesome. Well, I appreciate you doing that for the peeps. That's cool.
Yeah. Yeah, well, of course.
Awesome. So what's next for Vayner Experience? Any events coming up that you can talk about or divulge yet?
Yeah, I mean, we're dabbling a little bit. We always have a little bit of a presence at CES, which is the Consumer Electronics Show in Vegas. Mm-hmm. It's a big marketing event. So we'll be hosting some dinners there. We're also working on some the Cannes Lion Festival is another marketing event that we usually have a pretty decent presence at. So we're working through some stuff there. And then of course VoiceCon will come back. And so we're starting the planning on VoiceCon. It'll be back in New York. So we're starting that. And then we also do a ton of brand work, which, you know, I'm obviously always talking about these owned and operated proprietary events. But we have a lot of brand clients that have come to Vayner for social and digital services that are now looking to extend that experience through experiential. And so we have a bunch of our brands that we're working on as well that we have. Buy is a big client of ours, the juice company. And so we're working on some stuff for them. So yeah, we stay busy. We're a lean and mean team.
That's cool. That's really cool. How big is the Vayner Experience division?
Our core team is 3 people, but we obviously have support. So we leverage Gary's team for creative, and we have a media buying team that we leverage that's within the agency. So sort of all of the day-to-day work is done by three people, and then we leverage all of the internal resources that we have at hand.
Wow, you are lean and mean. That's fantastic.
Yeah, I know.
Impressive as hell, too. Jesus.
It's awesome. Actually kind of funny because like people will be like, oh, I was speaking to somebody on your social media pages. And I'm like, yeah, that was one of us. Don't worry about it. Like we're covering community management. We're covering, you know, strategy and creative. So it's always funny when people think that there's like this broad, huge team working to support these events. And it's, no, it's really us. You can guarantee you talk to one of us.
Yeah, yeah, I know. That was the impression I had. But that means you're doing a good job, you know?
Yeah. Thank awesome. You. And we obviously like leverage a ton of great partners. Like we have a production partner that helps on the production of our events. A Miami based company that I used to work with at the Orange Bowl company and they're wonderful. So yeah, we obviously enlist a ton of partners to support us, which we're thankful for.
Awesome. I just want to, I really want to encourage everybody listening. If there's any way in hell that you can make it to Miami on January 17th for this event, do it. Whether you're a realtor, a loan officer, a mortgage broker, a mortgage exec, you know, you run a brokerage, be there. Because look, I've been to Inman, I've been to a bunch of different real estate conferences, and they're all pretty much the same. And I'm not saying that they're not worth going to, but they're the same in that they're high level stuff. Like they talk about, you know, here you could do a few of these things. They don't really get into it. People keep going back just because their friends are there and for the networking. And, you know, there's not a whole lot of depth to it. But Agent 2021 is like, you guys don't give a shit about anything that isn't current. Like some of these other conferences, they're still talking about why you should start a Facebook business page. Right. And sessions on like how to have better direct mail campaigns and stuff like that. And that's like cool if that's what you're looking for. But you guys only care about what is working right now and what's going to work for the next, you know, the next 12 months or whatever. So it's as current of information as you could possibly get. And you get into the details with tactics and the whole experience of it all. So guys, go get a ticket if you haven't yet, because like Kim said, there's not a lot of them left. And I will be speaking on the mortgage track about content marketing and how to build a brand on with content marketing, which is going to be happening in the morning of the 17th. So be there for that. Kim, so you mentioned New York and VoiceCon is going to be there again, which is awesome. Uh-huh. Any excuse for me to get to New York, I'm there. VoiceCon last year was the first time I'd ever been to New York, and I'm obsessed with that.
Oh, scene. Nice.
That's there's awesome. Something about New York that just like to me, it's I'd rather go there than Bora Bora, which is weird. And to you, that you're probably
that
like,
is weird.
What is wrong with that guy? But yeah. So I'm excited for that. Quick travel awesome. Tip. Where do you fly into? Where's the best place to fly into if you're going into Midtown or, you know, that
I
area?
Go JFK always.
Really?
I always go JFK. LaGuardia is kind of a mess, to be honest with you. It's going through a whole, like, renovation. It's kind of a mess. I always go JFK. I also love JetBlue, which flies into JFK. So, that's usually my airport. Pretty easy.
Cool. Yeah, I'm flying into LaGuardia for Inman at the end of January, so that'll be interesting. I've never flown in there before, but
nice.
It looks like a cluster, but we'll hopefully
it
make
it
through.
It is a little bit of a mess.
Yeah.
You'll be fine. You'll be fine. Yeah. You'll muscle through it. It'll get you in the right mindset for New York, you know?
Exactly. Exactly. Well, Kim, thank you so much for being on the show. Before we go, I have some questions, some like either or rapid fire questions that I like to ask every guest.
Okay.
You know, so hopefully you've studied up and prepared for this one because it's grueling.
Oh, boy.
So I'm just going to go through the list. Tell me one or the other. And, you know, if you want to elaborate on some, cool, but you don't have to.
Okay.
Facebook or Instagram?
Instagram.
Instagram or Snapchat?
Instagram.
Book or podcast?
So I would say both. Book is usually for me like a lighter type of digestion of information. So beach reads, like really kind of like fun thrillers. I would say podcasting is a great time saver. So I try to digest all of my like business and information, health and wellness through podcasting. So really both, I guess. I don't do digital reads. So I do like, I like to hold a book and flip pages. No, I like to flip. I feel, you know what it is? Like when I finish a book, and I guess I used to read a ton before my daughter was born, and I've gotten back into reading. I feel productive when I finish a book, and I don't know that yep. I would have the same satisfaction that I would feel if I like read it digitally for whatever reason. I don't know what it is, man. It feels like, also I do everything like work related for me is digital. So it feels like a little bit of a pleasure to finish a book.
I can see that. Yeah. And I kind of get that sense of accomplishment when you finally finish off a book and you close it. There's something about closing.
Yeah. That sound.
Right? Yeah.
Yeah. I love it.
iPhone or Android?
And I also like re-gift. iPhone for sure.
Definitely. Alexa or Google Home?
Alexa.
Burgers or pizza?
Pizza. Pizza is my death row dinner. Like if I'm on death row, I'm going pizza and champagne. That is my dinner. There's a pizza for every occasion. It is my most favorite. Is my anniversary dinner every year. Pizza and champagne. That's it.
Ooh, I like that. And where's the best pizza in New York?
Lucali. That to me was like, I miss Lucali. So it's in Brooklyn. I actually think they opened one in Miami recently. So maybe when you guys are down for Agent 2021, you check out Lucali. But it's
nice.
A family-owned business. Yeah, Lucali. It wasn't far from where I lived in Brooklyn. It's a family-owned place. It's been there for years. It's BYO, so you can, you know, they don't serve any alcohol, but you can bring your bottles of wine if you want. And the pizza is just from another place. I mean, I think it's on the Netflix show Ugly Delicious, and it's gotten a little bit more popular because it was featured on there, but it is the best pizza.
Ooh, when I'm in New York for Inman, I'm going to check that out for sure.
Yeah,
I have some family over in Brooklyn. I'm going to be out there anyways.
Perfect. I'm sure they know it. They don't take reservations. It's one of those situations where you have to like go and you have to wait for your table. So in the winter, it's a little bit more manageable. In the summer, it gets busy because people obviously are going and they don't mind standing outside and waiting, but they do sort of, there's only like 10 tables inside. So they do sort of waves of seating, but it's delicious.
Awesome. Awesome. I'm excited for that. New York or LA?
Oof. I mean, I'm in LA, so I moved here 6 months ago. You know what? I love them both, to be honest. For me, I ended up back in LA because of the weather. I really need sunshine in my life, and New York became a little bit of a grind with the weather. But I also love New York. I'm a Yankees fan. I'm a Bills fan, which is the only New York team, Buffalo Bills.
I'm sure that goes over like a lead balloon in the office.
Yeah, it's great. I try to not schedule any meetings after Jets Bills games, although they both suck. So at this point, it doesn't really matter.
Right.
It's a tough call for me. I think as a family, I like being back in LA because for us, like we love to hike and bike and skateboard and scoot and surf and all that good stuff. So for us, from a lifestyle family perspective, I really love LA. But New York has an insane amount of energy in a small island, and you know, there's nothing that beats that feeling.
New York's pretty cool. LA is beautiful too. Totally different places. Which brings me to the next one. Mountains or beach?
Beach. That I will die facing the sun on the beach with my pizza and champagne.
Nice.
Beach for sure. Although I do love the mountains too. I'm a big hiker. I mean, that's like Mother's Day is always, I always ask just to go hiking. I really love, but we live really close to the beach now. So we're beach. I'm definitely a beach person for sure.
My wife's trying to get me to at least get a place in a more warm climate, LA, San Diego, South Florida, something like that. I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm a mountains guy.
But, you are mountains.
Yeah. I'm from Salt Lake. I've lived here forever. I love the four distinct seasons. I love winter. I love fall. I love everything. But yeah, getting to the beach is pretty awesome too.
Yeah.
No doubt.
The sound of the waves. There's nothing that beats the sound of the waves and the sunset.
Yeah, that's hard to beat that. Absolutely. So, okay, a question for someone not in the real estate industry. I'm curious your perspective. Is that real estate market overall in a bubble or no bubble?
I think it might be in a bubble.
Fair enough. It very well could be.
I mean, what do you think? What is your point of view?
I think it's in a bubble, but not the bubble we think of, like 2008. I mean, that was
bad
loans.
I don't think we're there.
Right. It's just overheated. It went up so damn high. It has to cool off a little bit, and then so. I would lean more towards no bubble myself, but I understand why you'd say bubble for sure.
It's funny. I actually like, and this may be, sort of a shift in generational thinking, but a lot more people are renting than buying.
There's more renting. Absolutely. Yep.
Because obviously the cost to buy is much more significant now. And the inventory to buy, we just moved to LA and we're looking to buy, and not only is it like enormously expensive, but just the inventory is just doesn't exist. So a lot of people are spending more, more their time as renters than buyers. And again, it could just be a generational thing, but, I'm hearing many more people like, their POV is like, I'd rather spend money traveling than on a mortgage. And I want to be able to like be flexible in my living situation. So who knows?
100% right. No, you're absolutely right. And there's definitely something generational with that. Like, you know, younger millennials, they don't want to be tied down really. They want to be able to bounce around to different places or open up to new opportunities. So that's a hell of a lot easier if you're renting, and it also depends on where you're at too. So, absolutely. That's you're right on with that. You're not wrong. Podcast or vlog?
That's a great question. I'm a visual person, which is why I kept answering Instagram and everything. Like, it's such a visual platform. So I love a vlog, but I do, going back to my earlier point about podcasting, I do find podcasting to be a time saver, and that, you know, I can digest it sort of anywhere. I don't need the visuals to, and I do like, and it's probably why I like reading, is I like to sort of create my own visuals when I'm reading, which is why I always like read the book before I see the movie, because I want to create my own. So I love a podcast for that, for obviously the ability to digest anywhere. But I do love, I love storytelling. I love visuals behind a vlog, and to really get to know somebody. Like, I think Gary's vlog has, you know, obviously been incredible for him and just people getting to know him. And I think to be able to see the action is really important. So yeah, it's tough. I mean, I like them both. I think it just depends on obviously the type of information that's either in the vlog or the podcast.
They're both so different. Like you said, the podcast mm-hmm. is more like passive listening. Like I listen to podcasts while I'm walking the dog every night and when yeah. I'm driving. But then video, like if I'm able to sit down at my laptop or on my phone, I'll watch video. Or I prefer it. So
right. yeah,
they're just different.
Yeah.
Well, they then that leads me to YouTube or Facebook Live.
YouTube or Facebook Live. I'm probably consuming much more YouTube than I am Facebook Live, to be honest with you. It's funny. I don't spend a ton of time on Facebook. I'm not like a big contributor on Facebook. I love keeping up with friends and family, you know, that I haven't seen in a while. I use Facebook personally much more for sort of like albums of, you know, seasonal activities. Like I'll probably do a holiday album more for, you know, my daughter has a profile on there. So it's more for legacy for her to have all of those images and whatnot. So I don't actually consume a ton of long form content. Now I do Instagram TV for sure.
Oh, you do?
But I think I'm spending more time. Yeah. I think I'm spending more time on YouTube from a video consumption perspective.
YouTube's hard to beat for sure.
Yeah, it is. It's easy.
Right. It's there forever. You know, it's easier to search. Mm-hmm. YouTube is
search. Yeah. Search is nice.
Absolutely. Final one, Uber or Lyft?
Uber.
Yeah.
I know it's very polarizing to say Uber.
It's like the Apple Android battle.
Right, I know. Uber, I was an early adopter of also. And I mean, to be fair, when I lived in New York, I Uber, Lyft, and Juno, I would just play the fare game. So I would call them all up when I needed to go somewhere and see which had the cheapest fare, and I would go for it, to be honest. But I would say from a default perspective, like I default to Uber out here now that I'm moving to LA. Juno doesn't exist, so I'm Uber or Juno or Uber or Lyft. But my first at bat when I'm doing a ride share is I go to Uber first.
Nice.
And then if it's outrageous, then I go back, then I go into Lyft. But yeah, Uber's my default.
And leave us with one app recommendation. Your favorite app right now. It doesn't have to be marketing, doesn't have to be, you know, just whatever. What's your favorite app right now that you recommend people get?
Oh gosh. Well, Instagram. But hopefully yes. You have Instagram already. Hopefully your community has Instagram.
Yes.
Okay, so one of my favorite, and it's obviously popped a bit more for me during the holidays because it's a photo sharing app. So I use it's a small app called Social Print Studio, and it was formerly known as Printstagram. So you could take all of your social photos and print them in sort of a high quality, sort of fun, unique gift that you can create out of photos. But it's super quick. It's like you just connect it to your social profiles. And then like I printed ornaments for my family. I my daughter, I do like yearly photos of, and, you know, print them out. We hang them. So Social Print Studio, formerly Printstagram, is one of my most used apps right now because I'm printing pictures like crazy for family and friends. And they have some like unique printing options for metals and wood and paper and all that good stuff. So
that would be good for realtors and loan officers for closing gifts or, you know, little gifts for their clients.
Yep, that. And they also do like fun business cards, like that sort of thing as well. And then I love Kira, which is it's connected to Instagram, but it's a way to sort of make your photos and videos sparkle. So I'm a big Kira fan. And then a friend of mine created an app called Card Lust. And this is really fun, sort of quirky cards that you can create, but you send through text. So a lot of holiday stuff going on. We had like last minute happy hours at our house for just, you know, a few friends. So I'm, instead of doing like a more formal invite or even like a paperless post, I just use Card Lust and I send
L-U-S-T.
A text with beautifully... Yep. Beautifully designed sort of text message that you just include your pertinent information. So it's a little bit, It's a little bit more classy than a text, but it doesn't go as like crazy or formal as a paperless post.
These are fantastic recommendations. I'm going to go get some of these.
So those are some of the ones that I'm using, I think, most frequently now because of the holidays. And then I'm looking at my home screen right now to see what other one. Venmo I use a lot.
Definitely.
Those are probably the big ones for me.
Awesome. Yeah. Cool. No, that's good stuff. I really like, you said Social Print Studio?
Yeah, Social Print Studio. They're a small company based out of SF. They do, like I said, they're like a very, very small, like family-friendly business, which I always like to support the underdog. So I think their customer service is phenomenal. They're a little bit quirky. So yeah, they're a fun little company for sure.
Love it. Thank you. Hey, Kim, I know you have another meeting to hop into real quick. So thank you so much for being on the Massive Agent Podcast today. Thanks for talking about Agent 2021.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. I'm so excited for that. Just a couple weeks out, about 3 weeks out. I assume you'll be around the event. I can come say hi, shake your hand.
Please. Yes. I would love that. And for any of your listeners, I would love for them to come over and say hello to me. I will be there all day, in and out. So definitely want to meet everybody that gets there.
Perfect. All right. Thank you so much, Kim. I appreciate it. And I will see you
in
a few weeks.
Sounds great.
All right. Take care. Well, after hearing from Kim, I don't know about you guys, but I'm so damn stoked for Agent 2021, and there's still time. This episode comes out on January 3rd. The event is 2 weeks after that, January 17th. You can still get tickets to Agent 2021. Just go to agent2021.com, enter the coupon code MASSIVEAGENT, and you'll get nearly 20% off the tickets versus without a discount code. So go do that. Join us there. I'm speaking in the morning on the mortgage track about content marketing and how to build a brand with content marketing. Chelsea Pites is speaking. Jason Fraser speaking. Ginger Bell. Jake Failing. Like there's so many great speakers that are going to be there. Speakers that I haven't met yet that I've heard about that I can't wait to meet. It's going to be an amazing, amazing event, as you just heard. Please go subscribe, or rather enable, our Alexa flash briefing called the Massive Agent Minute. We're like 180 episodes in at this point. We do one a day, 7 days a week, and it's an extension of this podcast. It's not just a clip of this show. So if you're thinking, well, I'm not going to do that because it's just a little clip of each podcast, it's not. It's totally original content, and we do not do clips of the show. It's in addition to this. So if you listen to the show and you want more than just the once a week podcast we do, go enable on your Alexa app or on Amazon desktop. You can just put it in the search bar, Massive Agent Minute, enable it, add it to your flash briefings on your Alexa device, and you'll get 60 to 90 seconds of extra original content every single day that goes along with this podcast. So also, if you would, those who have asked, and this is really cool. This speaks volumes about you guys, about our audience. I've had dozens of messages with people saying, hey, you know, like my market sold out with the Massive Agent Society, or I'm just not financially able to right now, but how can I give back to this show? How can I help the podcast? How can I help you guys bring value to you? Because I've been listening for almost a year and whatever. So first off, thank you. There are some things you can do to help us out. And so since you've asked, I'm not shy enough to respond. So number one thing you can do is leave us a review or a rating in iTunes if you haven't yet. Those who have, thank you. I can't tell you how much that means to us and how much it helps us. But it's like SEO for podcasts. iTunes is the platform where all the podcasts are, all the big ones. iTunes is the platform. It's like Google for websites. So reviews and ratings help us to rank better within iTunes. When somebody searches for a real estate podcast, a show with, you know, 150 reviews is going to show up better than a show with 5 reviews, which makes sense, right? So please help us to boost that. It'll help us grow our audience, which then will help us get bigger guests and provide more awesome stuff for you guys and more resources and everything like that. You can do that. You can just do it on your podcasting app, or if you prefer, plug in massiveagentpodcast.com/review, and it'll take you right to it to leave a review. You could also, this helps us out financially as well without any money out of your pocket whatsoever. you all shop on Amazon. We have an Amazon store, an Amazon affiliate account. So just go to massiveagentpodcast.com/Amazon, and that'll take you to our Amazon store. And then if you're buying stuff on Amazon, just all you have to do is go through our link through our store, buy whatever you were going to buy normally. And then through the affiliate program, we actually earn a small commission from that without, you know, it doesn't cost you any more, doesn't make the product more expensive. Amazon just pays us a little commission for sending the sale to them. So that helps us out as well to help us pay for hosting and equipment and, you know, all the stuff that we've got to pay for with this podcast that right now, honestly, comes out of my pocket. And that is super helpful as well. So massiveagentpodcast.com/Amazon. And since this is the first podcast of 2019, wow, I just realized that now at the very end of the show. Yeah, first podcast of 2019. How cool is that? But this is the time where a lot of people are thinking about a brokerage change. And so, you know, I switched in May, and I know some people don't care what time of year it is, but New Year's resolutions, people are thinking about changing brokerages, or at least they're more receptive to what else is out there that could be a better opportunity. I switched to eXp Realty back in May. I am extremely happy that I did. It's better than I thought it was going to be. There are more opportunities, and that those opportunities are bigger than I thought they were going to be. So I wish I would have done it a year prior. But nonetheless, it's an opportunity that if you're in that spot where you're thinking, is there something better? Is there a more advantageous brokerage for me? Are there more, like, what I keep hearing about this company stock that EXP agents get, or I keep hearing about the revenue sharing that's more lucrative than KWs. You know, what's that all about? If you just have those questions, go to massiveagentpodcast.com/EXP, click play on the video, and it'll visually lay it out for you, show you why EXP is growing so damn fast, why so many huge teams and top producing agents are switching to EXP, and it'll show you what I saw. It's one of those things that, you don't have to, by watching that video and seeing what EXP is all about, if you don't know what it's all about, educate yourself. Just, you know, it may be for you, it may not be for you, but either way is cool. Just make sure that you get the information so you know what all this hype in the industry is about. The hype is not empty. There's a reason for it. This video will show you what's up. MassiveAgentPodcast.com/EXP. And if you have more questions or it looks exciting to you and you want to explore working with me and my team at EXP, reach out, message me through Instagram at Massive Agent or our Massive Agent Podcast Facebook page. I'd be happy to answer your questions and talk about what that looks like. So thank you guys so much for listening. I hope you have an amazing 2019. I implore you, if there's any way in hell that you can get to Agent 2021 in 2 weeks, please do it. Get your ticket for 20% off at agent2021.com. Use the coupon code MassiveAgent, and you're going to get so much tactical education, tactical can't even think of the word. So many tactical things to do, and the networking there is going to be so powerful because it's all like-minded people, like this audience. Is, the stale loan officer that still wears a suit and, you know, they've been in the business for 40 years. This probably isn't for them, but you guys listening to this, that Agent 2020, man, I'm struggling. Agent 2021 is your scene. That's what you're looking for. Start the year off right. Start the year off on the right foot. I'll be there speaking. I'd love to meet you if you're going to be going to the conference. So let me know if you're going. Would love to meet up and say hi. But in the meantime, get your ass to work. It's 2019 already. Go have fun. Go work on. Go execute the plan that you've been putting together these last few months. And if you were one of those people that like 2019 is going to be my best year ever, now it's time to make that happen right now. Go do that. Have an amazing weekend. Take care. I'll see you guys next week. I just wanna get loose when the beat